Hello everybody, this is Cookie Rocks and welcome to the first Cup playoff race at Hotlanta for the NROL Colgate Cup Series. This is the Freightliner 400 and we just got done with the first national playoff race and now we're going to do our first Cup playoff race. And yeah, I recorded the whole thing before, but I accidentally pressed the play button for... I accidentally played the race button, and it immediately started the whole thing over. So, that's, dumb on my part. So, now I'm frustrated, and I really need to, get this out by... Sunday. Okay, I don't know what was that outside, but I'm not even gonna bother what that was. Anyways, from the regular season finale race, Joseph Tepetzal has scored his fourth win at Daytona. And obviously, due to him having four wins in total and having total points, he's obviously locked into the playoffs. So is the other drivers, except for Lance Smith Jr. Since we recently have 17 drivers that are able to be locked into the playoffs, and yeah, Lance Smith Jr. has sadly didn't make it, so. That's a rip on this part, but yeah. Anyways, alright, I'm gonna try not to lose my mind. I'll hopefully try to not mess anything up by the second time. Otherwise, I would just delay this race. Then do nothing by the whole day. And I really don't want any of that. But anyways, we're just gonna go ahead and get to our starting grid for tonight's Freightliner 400 race. Row 1 is Winnie Collin, that he is gonna be our new pole sitter for tonight's race. The long side with Winnie is Andrew Ramsey. Row 2 we got Donald Rahiman and Cutter Joey. Row 3 we got Sima Oskin and Logan Alexander. Row 4 we got Paul Jackson and Anthony Hernandez. Row 5 we got Joseph Tepetzal, the previous winner, and Nelson Reeves. Row 6 we got Ethan Hunter and Will Parrish. Row 7 we got Peter Jack and Priya McShane. Row 8 we got Rory Wimbledon and Riley Spurleytube. Row 9 we got Felix Jansen, Foster Anderson, sorry, and Mitchell Collins. Row 10 we got Keegan Thompson and Mike Maffer. Row 11 we got Lance Smith Jr. and William Brock. Row 12 we got Danny Bouchard and Stefan Alexander. Row 13 we got Roberto Crown Jr. and Roman Fenway. 14 we got Brad Stover and Juan Rodriguez. Row 16 is that right? Yeah, we're 15. Alright, my bad. We're 15, we got Alexander Kelly and Christian Vargas. We're 16, we got Dexter Black and Andre Bernaskis. We're 17, we got Lance Smith Jr. and Beefy Creed. We're 18, we got Owen Miles and Felix Jansen. We're 19, we got DJ Reed and JJ Reed. Row 20, we got Jack Wimbledon and Kyle Hunter. And finally, on row 21 is Trace Smith, starting last. Not a good qualifying position for him, but it wouldn't matter. Anyways, that's going to be it for the starting grid of tonight's Freightliner 400. So we will go ahead and get to your command, then the race report. Once until the pace car gets itself back to the pit lane for a second time in Atlanta, we'll start things off with a bang, for our first playoff race of the season.
Drivers, start your engines!
Engines have been fired up with our Cup Series drivers that are ready to get their first playoff race started. As the pace car will walk off to turn 3 and turn 4, we will go ahead and show you the race report. 65 laps for this Cup race, and we got 100.10 miles here in Atlanta. Pit windows will be at least either Freightliner or 40 to 43 laps. Previous winner is Joseph Tebbutsall, and this is our third Cup 2018 mod race at Atlanta. As the pace car has gotten itself back to the pit lane, we are green for the Freightliner 400 at Atlanta World Speedway. We're starting things off with Paul Jackson as our leader. I mean, Dylan Nopperhuman was the leader at the start, but now it's 78. Never mind. It's going to be Ethan Hunter that had made a free wide pass with Joseph and Paul Jackson. So, Ethan is going to be the new leader. Lap 3. Doy for Potter, if you hear my dog barking downstairs, I'm just doing this in one take. If I do another takes than that, then I'm gonna be done. I thought I saw someone pitting, but someone have not pitted that early, so never mind about that. Anyways, Frost Anderson, the new leader in the 77, was, but not anymore though. At least he's still side by side with Paul Jackson. Can he block the 17? Yes, he can. He'll continue his lead position. This is just blocked the 17. But the lead position for the 15 won't last by a little few seconds. And now that lead position has given to Joseph Tebbutsall. And by the way, we're gonna see a lot of passing here at Atlanta, so expect like a lot of drivers that are gonna be passing here at Atlanta. But yeah, the points leader and the previous winner who won at Daytona is now leading again. At least not leading again at this track, but yeah. And Daniel Bouchard couldn't quite catch up to the 17 car's drift, so yeah. There goes Alexander Kelly. I thought he would easily past the 17, but they're still going side by side by the next lap. As the 17 still got the lead lap, another lead lap. And man, Alexander just really trying to battle against the 17, but couldn't really win that side by side battle against him. There's Joey. I almost call him Joey Logano. That's Mitchell Collins in the 22, aka the Joey Logano fan, but yeah, he became the new leader after passing the 17. by turn 1 to turn 2. Mike Meffer for second. Before create a third, now it's gonna pass to 24 for second place, and may pass the leader for the lead, or that Brad Silver will be taking that lead away from from the 22. It's gonna be the 42. Brad Stover that's gonna be leading by now. Something wrong with my voice. Anyways, but yeah, Brad is now leading. As you can see that all these drivers have usually wanna make it free wide at Atlanta. Now the leading position will go to Nelson Reeves. Nelson Reeves in the 10. Now he goes to the outside lane. That will definitely give Owen Miles a chance to lead now. So yeah. The 12 is side by side with Nelson. But he's still gonna tip you over the lead pretty easily still, and what happened? Oh, okay, well Beefy Creed have pitted early. Might have had some issues from the car, but I'm glad that I'm glad that nothing broke from the freight driver. It could have either have been a header problem or a piston problem, but it's none of those. It just changed some tires, and I think that's pretty much it. I don't think he needs fuel, but I don't know, he might have pitted for fuel too. But it just seems that it looks like they have only pitted just for tires. So that might have been a problem for the free driver. Anyways, we got two Joe Gibbs Racing drivers. 1 and 2. Dylan Upperhuman, Ethan Hunter side by side. As they're both playoff drivers, and I think these two are the only JGR drivers that made it to the playoff grid. So yeah, Paul Jackson have taken a lead lap away from the 19. So oh god. Don't. Oh, Jesus. But yeah, anyways, Paul Jackson will be the leader now. For now. And yeah, like I said, there's gonna be a lot of passing Atlanta, so I pretty much expect a lot of good drivers that are gonna be battling each other for the lead. We must see sometimes for the win by the last few laps. But yeah, anyways. Now there goes Lennon Johnson to the lead now in the 51 Rick Ryder Racing Machine. A little bit further away than the rest, but it's not a big deal. It's not like a big deal for all these drivers. They can still catch up to the leader anyways. got Ethan Hunter on Miles side by side, but now Ethan will definitely get second. Mike Manfred to the inside, Ethan to the outside. Fake Mike. Mike Manfred will get second next. And I'm pretty sure he hasn't tried to pass the leader yet, but he is gonna try to do that at turn 3 and turn 4 at least. So there he goes. Still to the inside lane and will easily get the lead away from the 51. At least. But, yeah. Still have gone a little bit to the inside lane just to block the 43. And he's not gonna try to go to the inside lane again, so that will be given to Christian Vargas. B3 Creed. Bottom make it free wide. At least a little bit of free wide. But it's most likely going for the lead though, so there he is. He is leading in the free now. Lennon Johnson back to second place. Will he try to get his lead back or will he not? We'll see if that will happen, but I don't know, maybe the other drivers can try to pass two of these drivers. But yeah. B3 is still leading so far. So